Welcome to Easy Learning Economics. I'm Dr. Cavill. Today we are going to learn about saving investment equality, in which we learn that how saving and investments are equal under two-sector economy or closed economy. Our lecture plan is based on these points, that what are those assumptions on the basis of it that saving and investments are equal under two-sector economy. How the saving and investments are equal and how the saving and investments are equal are shown in national income accounts, and what are those conditions for the constancy of circular money flow under two-sector economy. So this is our lecture plan. We assume that all the savings of household come in the financial market and there are no inter-household borrowing. It is business firms who borrow from the financial market for investment in capital goods to increase production. Through investment expenditure by borrowing, the savings of household deposited in financial market are again brought into the expenditure stream, and as a result the total flow of spending does not decrease. How saving investments are equal? As we know, in our two sector simple economy, neither government nor foreign trade, as we learned in two sector economy, that economy is self-sufficient in consumption and production. It means economy has no relation with the rest of the world. There is absence of exports and imports. In two-sector economy, we have covered these things. So in our two-sector simple economy with neither government nor foreign trade, investment is identically equal to the savings. I stands for the investment, S stands for the savings. So I is equal to S means investments are equal to the saving. In simple economy, the value of output produced, which we denote by Y, is equal to the value of output sold. Y means the GDP. Since the value of output sold in simple two-sector economy is equal to the sum of the consumption expenditure and investment expenditure, we have Y is equal to C plus I. It means that the total output would be equals to the consumption plus investment. This is the equations we have derived, where Y is the value of aggregate output and C is the consumption expenditure and I is the investment expenditure. Thus, gross national product GNP produced is used either for consumption or for investment. Now look at the gross national product or income in the simple economy from the viewpoint of its allocation between consumption and savings. National income, which is equal to the GNP, can be either consumed or saved. Output would be equals to consumption plus saving. This is another identity or second equation we have derived. We have derived these two equations, that Y is equal, total output would be equals to the consumption plus investment, or total output would be equals to the consumption plus savings. From these two identities, identity 1, equation 1 and 2, we get another equation that is in the form of this, that the consumption plus investment is equal to the output and consumption plus saving is equal to the output. So it means Y is the total output here, and that is from income side and other from expenditure side. C plus I, it is means this is from expenditure side, and C plus S is the income side equation. From the identities 1 and 2, we get this equation C plus I is equal to Y is equal to C plus S. It means the income of country must be equal to the expenditure of the country. Thus, the identity 3 shows that the value of output produced or sold is equal to the total income received. It is income received that is spent on goods and services produced. Now, by subtracting the consumption from both sides of the identity 3, we have investment is equal to savings. Thus, in our two-sector simple economy with neither government nor foreign trade, investments are identically equal to the savings. In national income accounts, saving investment identity. This is the mathematically expressions we see here, that this is the income side, that total output, as we learned here, that the equal to the consumption plus saving. This is from income side equation, and from expenditure side, that the total output Y is equal to C plus I, it is from expenditure side. So consumption plus saving is equal to total output. Total output would be equals to the C plus I. So by subtracting the consumption from both sides, we get saving is equal to investment. You can see here that the economy achieves equilibrium at this point when the saving and investments are equal. What are the conditions for the constancy of circular money flow? The saving is withdrawal of some money income from income flow. Our saving is a deviation of income from spending. On the other hand, the investment is injection of some money in circular flow of income. The flow of money income will continue at a constant level only when the condition of equality between the planned saving and investments is satisfied. Otherwise, the planned saving and investment will not be equal. So the rate of interest, which is the price for the use of saving, is determined by the saving and investment. It was believed by classical economists that financial market provides a mechanism which coordinates the saving of household and the investment expenditure by the firms. The circular flow of income proves that. What does it prove? It proves that the national expenditure is equal to national income and national income is equal to national output. It is all about the saving investment identity or saving investment equality. Under two-sector economy, we have already delivered a lecture on two-sector economy. If you would like to watch, so you can. So it is all about this. If you have any question or query, you can ask me in comment box. Thanks for watching.